Mayor Lederer, members of the City Council, members of the School Board, Treasurer Maloney, Commissioner of the Revenue, Paige Johnson, Clerk of the Court Fry, Senator Peterson, Delegate Bulova, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. The last 8 weeks have been overwhelming. It is with heartfelt appreciation for your confidence and trust that I become the ninth individual to serve as mayor of the City of Fairfax. Some of you have heard me say in the past that there's no higher honor than serving as a member of your City Council. Well, that was until tonight. I've known many mayors. First and foremost, the man who raised me, my father, the late Frederick W. Silverthorne. He served as mayor from 1978 to 1982. My father taught me the importance of public service and that you have no right to sit on the sidelines if you're going to complain. It's not lost on me that I'm assuming the office of mayor a full 30 years later after my father's departure from elected service. I only wish he could be here today. I am fortunate, however, to have my entire family with me today, some traveling great distances, to be here to support me, and their support means more than they will ever know. They're all sitting right here. Thank you all. I also want to mention others that have had a profound impact on my life and have been my mentors in public service. First, the man I served with from 1990 to 2012, Mayor John Mason. John, are you here? There he is. As a newly elected council member in 1990, John taught me the importance of using my position for the common good and to always keep my finger on the pulse of the community. That advice served me well for nearly two decades. John also exemplifies what a great former mayor should be all about, remaining active in the community when most of us would choose to ride off into the sunset. Thank you, John. And of course, the man I've served with most of the past decade, Mayor Robert Lederer. Rob is a gifted leader who has achieved great success as mayor. His many achievements have been touted repeatedly, but the most notable include our ranking by Forbes magazine as the third most livable community in America for a city of our size, the achieving of the coveted AAA bond rating, which recognizes the city's sound fiscal management, and the gold medal award, which we won just recently by the National Recreation and Parks Association, one of only four jurisdictions to win this award in Virginia over the past 45 years. Well done, Mr. Mayor. I'm especially proud of our City Council tonight. You don't have to look far, only across the Potomac River, to see how not to govern. We are a collegial group with a sense of mutual respect for dealing with the challenges that face us ahead. I have known most of these individuals for many, many years and consider them all to be friends. I'm certain that we can work together even when we don't always stand together. Friends, the City of Fairfax is rich in history with unlimited possibilities for our future. From our unique and diverse neighborhoods, low taxes, outstanding services, a world-class university right on our border, and our strong cultural and recreational amenities, we have a quality of life unparalleled in the Washington metropolitan region. While living near the nation's capital has insulated us somewhat from the worst economic hardships that face the rest of the country, we have also not been totally immune from some economic challenges. Our unemployment rate and poverty rates are up in the city, and our local economy continues to struggle with residential property values. While I hope the worst has indeed passed us by, we must also not be complacent. Just this year, we faced one of our worst budget scenarios that we've ever faced in our city's history. This was driven largely by a combination of flat revenues and large increase in school expenses. These challenges, along with demands for city services, will only compound our economic challenges going forward. Over the past few years, we've seen a chipping away of some city services, including cuts to public safety staffing, certain capital projects, backyard trash service, and city publications. While I'm the first to suggest that shared sacrifice in tough times may be necessary, we also must not forget the virtues that made this city great. Our people, our common sense leadership, and our very proud traditions. We should create honest and realistic priorities for the future, which reflect our shared vision for this future. And with the City Council concurrence, we will do just that. Every City Council member campaigned that a growing local economy is key to the city's long-term health. We must focus our energy to redevelop Fairfax Boulevard and continue our progress in our historic downtown. I will also urge the City Council to pursue opportunities to streamline local government, including a top-to-bottom review of regulatory burdens faced by existing businesses that want to expand or new businesses that want to locate here in the city. As Chris Lineberger recently pointed out in a New York Times editorial, demand for walkable urban space now extends beyond city centers and into the suburbs. Many residents want easy access to grocery stores, cafes, libraries, and they want to get out of their cars to walk, use transit, and bike. And we have also heard locally that young families, baby boomers, and seniors want to sell their large houses right here in the city of Fairfax and move to a walkable urban place, but stay close to family and friends in the community that they've always called home. As mayor, I will work closely with our local neighborhoods and business leaders to promote responsible economic development so that we can grow our local economy while also minimizing future tax rate increases. And yes, ladies and gentlemen, we can have both. We can move forward with growth while also protecting and enhancing our residential quality of life. I am asking each and every one of you, business people, residents, elected leaders, to help me in this effort and to keep an open mind and to keep our eyes on the future of the city of Fairfax. As for the future, I also strongly believe it's time, sorry, water's falling here. I also believe it's time to develop a citywide strategic plan and perform a long overdue review of our city charter. While I'm not suggesting wholesale change, our last strategic plan was done in 1994 under the leadership of Mayor John Mason. Nearly 20 years is too long. And it's been even longer since we've done a comprehensive review of our city charter, aspects of which Mayor Robert Lederer shared his concerns about a few weeks ago at his farewell address at City Hall. As mayor, I know we can't be an island unto ourselves, and the city of Fairfax's views must always be represented regionally. We must work closely with our neighbors in Fairfax County and George Mason University and throughout the region if we're going to continue to grow and prosper. And it's no secret that our community continues to diversify. When Rob Lederer graduated high school, I won't tell you the year, way back when, our minority population in the city was just over 2%. When I graduated high school 10 years later, 1984, our minority population was just over 8%. Today, our minority population is over 40%. So 2% to 40%. In the Fairfax County school system alone, we have over 100 languages being spoken. By some counts, way more than that. I believe we've turned a blind eye to this trend, and it's a trend we must not continue to ignore. As mayor, I will do everything within my power to see that every citizen of the city has an equal opportunity to participate fully in our community. As a first step, I will ask the City Council to consider diversity on our boards and commissions so they can accurately reflect our community. Finally, we should continue Joan Cross's legacy of promoting tourism as another means of developing local jobs, increasing revenues, and take advantage of our outstanding city events, historic resources, and close proximity to our nation's capital. Ladies and gentlemen, I've been proud to serve on your city council, and I'm deeply honored to serve as your mayor. Your mayor has to know and understand the community. I pledge to listen and understand all sides of an issue before making a decision. Only by maintaining your respect, your confidence and trust, and that of the members of the city council, can I be effective in representing your interests here in City Hall. Even today, with people in government caught in an economic squeeze, I remain optimistic about our future. I believe we have the resources, the talent, and the good sense to meet the challenges that face us in the years ahead. There is much more to be done, and it can't all be done from behind the dais here at City Hall. As your mayor, I will continue Rob Lederer's legacy to meet with you, attend neighborhood meetings, and host community outreach meetings whenever necessary to address the major challenges facing our community. By working together, we can continue to make City Hall even more responsive. I thank you all for being here tonight, and God bless the City of Fairfax.